Now, once you get the prophecy, you get involved now because the children of Israel didn't enter into the rest because they didn't believe. Mm. And I'm going to close with this point right here because I want you to get this. You could dance about a prophecy all you want. If you don't follow instruction,
that's right.
You're not going to walk in it.
That's right. That's right. Forfeit.
Come on.
That's right.
Hallelujah. They left out of Egypt with a promise that I'm giving you a land. Two of them made it to the land because only two people believed them. Mm. Mm. All the people who made it to the land were born in the wilderness because they were full of Egypt. Amen. See what I'm saying? So you gotta understand it. Look, don't get upset when these people walk into the door. These young people walk into the door. Don't get upset when you see them on the podium.
Lord.
Because they come in here hungry and want to do something different. Y'all ain't talking back to me because that's what God does. All the people who left out of Egypt, none of them made the problem because they couldn't believe. They couldn't do nothing different.
Yeah.
They couldn't get that bondage out of their mind. Glory to God. They couldn't get that. They were slaves. They couldn't understand that they were people who were powerful. So they had to die. And what's the most process that all bodies are
not.
All of us Sunday.
Many of us will end up dying in what's supposed to process us. Because we're not looking at it from the perspective of God. And we're giving the devil credit for what God is doing. And we quit in the things that's supposed to process us. We give up and we stop going to church and we stop believing and we stop praying in the things that's supposed to process us. I'm still going to preach this here. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So as I get ready to close here, I receive from you. I feel received from you. I receive from people who can receive the word when we need to see. Listen, I'm not preaching for them. I know some of y'all come up to preach tonight. But I want y'all to just stop for a minute. I just want to talk to you. If you ever heard anything I said before in these 16 years, your life, you are in a place of favor.
Yes, Lord.
The favor of God is on your life.
Yes, it is.
Hear me when I tell you this. You have to start expecting the favor to be on your life. And in every situation. Because if you go in there speaking against it, you're fighting with the truth. Once the promise, is
released,
that's grace. God's grace is on it. It takes your faith to connect to that.
Yes, yes.
What is your faith? I have confidence in God and I'm going to speak what God said. I'm not always feel like it, but I'm going to speak it.
Yes.
I'm not always look like it's working, but I'm going to speak it. Why? Because I have a word. And now for those of you who came, you know that these things have already been written in the book of life past. Everything in your life, because you say, is already predestined and written and confirmed. So all God wants us to do now is attach to that. What the enemy's going to do? He's going to show up with his side of the story.
Hey.
Y'all not talking back to me. He's going to show up, like he's going to show up with discouragement. And I ain't got to keep telling the end of the spirit.
Yeah.
Can I testify since I'm honest like that?
Yeah.
After a great big day yesterday, after me writing about warfare, and God showing me how to fight warfare and not get in my flesh.
Yes.
At the end of the day, I had to discuss my wife and been straight to my flesh.
Wow.
He was teaching me something. And she tried to tell me, you want it right now. You know, I'm saying that right now. So I'm saying that. But listen, I'm teaching you because I want you to get it. I'm not going to profess you I'm perfect. I wrote about how the enemy will come in and get you to see something a certain way, get your thoughts back in your past, and because your thoughts in your past, your emotions now, you're angry, you're hurt, you're frustrated, all the emotions kicking because of what you think about what somebody said, you know what I'm talking to, and now because the emotions kicking up, you start acting on that. And after writing all of that, something happened.
Yep.
And I went right back to yesterday.
Yes.
Okay, come on.
And my thoughts went to yesterday.
Come on.
And my emotions of anger began to kick up big bang, and frustration. And I couldn't catch myself before I started acting on it.
Man.
And all of a sudden I'm speaking out of my mouth things I shouldn't say.
Come on.
I didn't go. Somebody say when I didn't go. And if I would have gone, he'd eat me. Amen. But what happened was, what happened was, I had to lay down in the bed. I just went to lay down and said, I'm going to just separate myself from it. And it was so hard, even when I knew I was wrong,
yeah.
It was so hard for me to say, I'm sorry. Because that spirit grabbed the hold of me.
That's right.
My Lord.
I thank God for what I know today. I thank God that I can overcome this kind of thing, because this could be going on for days. If I didn't understand that this is nothing but a spirit, yeah. That I'm on an appointed schedule, and these things come to try to get me off schedule, yeah. And I had to admit to her, you know what, I handled it the wrong way. Because she's steady trying to apologize before I'm accused of, and I don't hear it. Mm-hmm. Because I was already in my zone running.
Come on.
Anybody else here? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So, as I close, Shanda, I'm closing with this right now because I feel the gift of Jesus Christ in here. You, what you're dealing with has nothing to do with feelings and thoughts. You're in a kingdom. And what the enemy's going to try to get you with is thoughts that go to feelings, that go to action. And every time you do that, he got you.
Yeah.
Because once you get to the power of action, it's hard to pull you back.
Yes,
if you don't get yourself at the place of thought, it's going to be a fight.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's all right there. But if you take it, and you see it, and you have the experience, and you put the word in it first. Okay, I'm closing now. You put the word there first. Okay, husband, love your wife, and wife, love the church, and Christ, love the church. Put the word there first. Be kind, be gentle, be patient. Put the word there first. And obey the word. And no matter how you're feeling, it's going to turn out totally different.
Yeah.
Are we here?
Yeah.
So I'm just giving you my testimony. That's what happened to me. Let us stand, please. I'll be getting ready to go. But what I want to do, I want you to walk with me in a little bit. And remember, next Sunday, we're going to have service at 12. Amen. From 12 to 1:30, quarter to 2. Because it's Christmas Eve, and I want people to give people a few more minutes to do what they got to do. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
So, I want to get this into you, and I really want you to get it, as I close it. We as a ministry, our assignment is, and the Lord made it clear to me, our assignment is to liberate people. We believe that people who confess Jesus saved. So we're not going to judge nobody once they saved. Because once a person gets saved, they're on God's calendar now.
Amen.
And everything about their life is already perfected. They don't need my approval nor yours.
Say it.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
What we need to do is focus on our journey.
Yes. Thank
and see
you.
The part that they play in our lives.
Yeah.
Because they may have to walk with us for a season to get us somewhere.
Yeah.
But if you're so busy judging and you can't get from them what they came to give you,
yes.
You ought to talk them back to me.
Yes.
Because there's so many people who love the Lord, who can affect this kingdom, not in church, because we have the wrong idea about church.
Yes.
About the people who come in there. And you gonna pull your pants up. Man, my pants might be too small. I don't say nobody. Are you all here with me?
Yes.
So we're gonna love people. We're gonna love them with all our hearts, all our mind, and we're going to establish this kingdom of God. Are you all here with me?
Yeah.
We're gonna get our apostles in place, our evangelists, our prophets in place. And our pastor teachers in place. Because pastors and teachers are not two different offices. That's one office.
Thank you.
The key office is the Holy Spirit. And that's the one we keep leaving out of fivefold. The key office in the fivefold is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And when everybody teaches about it, they leave them out.
Mm-hmm.
If I send Cornelia, come here. I'm done. Cornelia worked with me, right? I want to tell you all something. And I send Cornelia to tell you. And she works in a place. What's her name?
Kiki.
Kiki works in a place where Cornetta's coming, right? But she shuts Cornetta out totally. But she still says she's speaking for me. How can she speak for me if she ain't here for Cornetta? Are you understanding the concept? So when we take the Holy Ghost out of the government, we disconnect from God. Oh, this is good to get. She belongs here. She belongs here. So I'm going to let you go right now. I'll let you go.
Sorry.
I want you to just lift your hands for me for a minute. And then we're going to go. We're going to receive our offering. I want you to open your hands like this. Glory to God. And I want you to tell yourself I'm in receiving mode in this season.
Yes, I am.